people starting with me. You know, you don't need to go to Starbucks, you just start with people. It's amazing what people can do with social media nowadays. So yeah.
Kids, right? They have these eggs that you open and then they just give their comments. So it's just their hands and the toys, and they open up the eggs and, oh, is this today? I'm getting this toy. And they just make a description out of it. And millions and millions of
people. He's Brian, he's a 6-year-old boy. He's the highest paid YouTuber in the world right now. Six year old, right? Yeah. He just opens toys and plays with them. I don't know, my parents, they should have done that. Save a lot of toys.
Okay, now, how about some questions from the floor? Anyone have any questions? Just from,
My question is to everyone, right? You guys are promoting content, but this is supposedly organic content. I mean, something you came up with. So, when do you realize you need to start promoting them as opposed to I want this to go organically viral? Okay. Was it from the start or at a certain point in time?
Okay, for my Instagram, it was organic maybe until 50k. Yeah, and so I guess I would say you judge your organic growth until it plateaus. I would say after it plateaus, then you realize that, okay, they want you to start spending money. Yeah, because they're not going to give you the exposure anymore. Yeah. Actually, I would say around 50k. Yeah, so that's for me personally, maybe the rest.
No, but
first,
it's
like
your Instagram.
Hard to see, as I mentioned, I believe in organic growth, like putting hashtags or I don't know, getting viral. But in our case, it was not really working well. I mean, we got some followers, but not much. I would say like 100 per week or so. So of course, we wanted a bigger growth. So we found out after some time that we really need to invest, start investing some money into.
Most of you guys are saying 50,000, it's just 50,000. I'm like stuck at 500 right now. So how do you even get 50,000?
You're at 30,000, so maybe you're
saying
it's really different.
I think as a brand per se, right, can I ask what kind of content do you churn out on your different social media platforms?
Right, so now I'm just capturing my life journey. Like what I'm doing, I wake up in the morning, I go for a run, I take a run, I write an article, I say I'm writing, I'm eating something nice, I say I'm eating.
That's the problem.
That's the journey.
Yes. Yeah. That's the problem, because you don't have a direction, I think. So for social media, right, if you see, because Instagram algorithm is ever changing, so you don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. So for you, for the brands as well, or for personal as well, you need to stay coherent, I would say. You cannot be like, today, wow, I'm eating, and tomorrow you're swimming. Today you are like a food lover, and tomorrow you're like a fashion kind of thing. So for me, I don't really, mine is really organic growth, unless a brand that works with me asks me to pump in some money to do a sponsor ad for that thing. If not, mine is really organic. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, maybe I think you start from doing something that you coherent.
Hi. How do you deal with negativity on social media and cyberbullying? Like, if someone sends negative comments or says something about your physical appearance, facial appearance, or something you're doing, how do you deal with it?
Thank God I don't get any.
Oh, you don't get
it? No, I don't get anything on my digital. Because I don't want food.
Like, sounds like any?
Actually, right, I mean, social media is very hard to avoid this kind of comment. So I think you have to take it with a pinch of salt. Because some people, I mean, there's bound to be people that like your content. And people who, for me, I think some of them, it's not like the one that you're going to target. So I'm still okay with that, actually. Lifestyle should have more.
Okay, this is something that I was fully aware of going into social media, something that I was also very scared of, but for the sake of my career, I had to. I came out in the period of time where it was like Sasha and all that, you know, drama, people fighting, court cases, goodness know what. And I know comes its consequences. And I'm just, for myself personally, I'm very thankful to have friends and family that are my bedrock. So I know that the people who mind don't matter and the people who matter don't mind. Yeah, and that is what holds, like, keeps me comforted whenever there's like horrible comments. Yeah, or you can just block them.
But do you somehow encourage them to change, to maybe spread more joy and kindness on social media by responding to their comments? Because if you're ignoring it, that means you're not addressing the case.
Okay, I will ignore sometimes, because if you do engage with them, honestly, with some trolls, it is a never-ending thing. I tried that once. The very first time, I realized it's not going anywhere. They will just keep on, they will continue the conversation with you. So you can't change anything about people. But what I do see a lot of influencers nowadays doing is that they bring up. So, you know, I have a fitness influencer that I follow, Casey, from Poppy Artists. She posts, you know, the comments that people say, you're so fat, how can you be a fitness blogger? You're cellulite, how can you do this? She posts about them on her Instagram to show the girls and the young girls that are following her that it's okay. You know, even the most beautiful people get shot down, and then she uses that to teach them a lesson. I don't believe you can change those trolls. If they want to change, they'll change themselves. But if not, then just take it as a lesson. If you're being cyber bullied, take it as a lesson. And like I said, kill them with kindness. Yeah.
Thank you. Anyone else? Any questions? Feel free. Yeah, gentlemen.
I would like to ask first of all about the ads. You said $200 per week for Instagram and $100. But what about Facebook? I mean, I would like to, how, in Instagram, I think it's easy and clear. But when it comes to Facebook, I find it's a bit difficult, and I don't know what to do about it. This is the first question. The second question about, I think for a girl, it's easy to go viral or to become influencer. Just, it's not very difficult, anymore. But when it comes to men, let's say, for a guy, what do you think?
So the first question about Facebook, right? So I can just share our experience. So because our target is millennials, Indonesian millennials, so they are mostly on Instagram nowadays, and they don't really spend time on Facebook. Sometimes they just use it as messenger, but they don't really scroll through. Yes, we invested some money on Facebook, but it really didn't really see much engagement. So on Instagram, it works perfectly for us. I mean, it's really growing so fast, especially if you invest some money. But for us on Facebook, it doesn't really work well. And we are on Facebook as well. And we post there, like, we just repost some articles that we post on our website. But the engagement is really not that much. I think if you want to go to Facebook, you really need to what kind of audience you want to attract. If it's like older people, or probably there is a chance, but I think really Instagram is so much more powerful in attracting people to content. And in addressing your second question about how men can become popular on Instagram, I think there are so many men out there who are super popular on Instagram, and I think I follow some who are like travel bloggers, because they really take really great pictures and take great stories, Instagram stories. So what kind of information do you want to put out there on your Instagram or Facebook? What kind of travel, what kind of blogger do you want to become?
Business.
I think it's really a huge opportunity to become a business blogger on Instagram. I would personally follow you. I think if you put out there really good content, I think there is really a need on Instagram, like for travel bloggers, for business bloggers.
Yeah.
But how you become is, I think, just following the advice, like passion and building good content, visual content, and promoting the content. I hope I answered your question.
Thank you.
Thank you.
sorry, to add on to your question on Facebook, right? I think the best way, right, is to come up with a few ad sets. So you put a small amount of budget on different ad sets, and then you see which one is working the best, which target group that you targeted is the best, and then you pump more money into the ad set. So instead of like pumping one shot of your money into one particular asset, you do a few assets. That's how I did with my client. So one of my clients, Tian Kok, he wanted to reach out to more millennials, right? So it'd be best to target, like, we have different assets, like people who love Insta or people who, okay, so you know which one is performing better, you put more money inside it, and the rest you can just pump it inside. So, yeah. So you just now mentioned that you want to do business, right? I think for me, I'll follow people with like more finance content. So I mean, millennials want, they'll grow up eventually to manage their own finance, right? Somebody who shares finance, I'll be very interested in. Yeah.
Any final questions? Okay.
Hi, I'm my name is Louis. So I just started the journey of self-awareness coaching. So my question is, I just started my Facebook official page. And I understand from what you're saying, millennials don't like long posts, right? So, but my posts are more of a reflective one. So it's about a mid to long body length. So is that actually relevant for millennials, or you know, should I just cut it out to probably about 4 or 5 sentences? What's your take on that? And that's number one. Number two, do I post now, because we have relatively, I have only probably 10 posts now. Should I wait till I have maybe 40 contents before I start posting? And then the final question, sorry, is that do I reach out through Facebook writings, or do I do videos content?
I think long contents are okay. I mean, it depends on what kind of industry you are in. For you, I think long contents are okay, but I don't know what's the response like for now.
Okay, so because I'm not posting posts, I do get like, I tend to end with a question. So for people,
I think that's a good way.
Yeah, that's an engagement, but because the engagement comes from my direct friends, so I'm not yet posting posts, so my struggle is that probably my posts are mid to long term. I'm not sure that it's really, you know, good enough to catch millennials. Yeah.
Now what I said earlier, millennials, their attention span is really short. So I would say you have to like really summarize everything like shorter. Because honestly, nowadays videos, right, people don't really watch the entire video like last time. That's why, you know, NOC, their videos right last time is like very long, but then all kind of short because the attention span of millions is very short. If they are not interested in the first few seconds maybe, they really like off it already. So maybe you can concise your content itself. And then pictures wise, obviously must have something that is very visually appealing to them. So because the first thing that comes from Facebook, Instagram is the picture itself. So if it doesn't catch their attention, right, they won't even bother to look at the content. And for the boosting part, right, I think create more content first. I mean, 10, I think, is still a bit too little at the moment. I think maybe when you have about 30 to 40, when you have a good package of it, and then you know what your readers like as well, your content, then you know which kind of boost to target who. Hopefully I answered the question.
Long posts are not necessarily bad for millennials. In our case, 80% of our posts are very long, and some people, even like my friends, they told me like, why you post such long posts? But actually, we even did a survey among our followers, and like 85% told us that they still prefer long posts because they want to know more details about Singapore. So it's really like, if you mentioned that your page is informational, so I guess like 80% of your content can be long, but maybe 20% could be like more like short, you know, just to make them different. And also in terms of how to catch the attention, I think in our case,
I think for culture, it's quite a different sphere and industry compared to maybe yours. Like if you're following Lewis House, the Alexis Banayanki is the third door author, Tony Robbins, they have very different content, especially for coaching. You can't explain or you can't discuss something in three sentences. So what they do nowadays is they record a video, they publish it on YouTube. That's one, for the exposure. The second one, now it's like there's a big market on podcasts. So for example, you can launch your podcast, you can invite guests, interviewers, for example, the same friends like this to share their experience, or again, like this cyberbullying, self-awareness, that's for coaching, there's a huge topics to discuss. And I think that's at least how they work on that. I think we should look more into that because this is gonna be different. On Instagram, you can make a short 1 minute video and say, oh, we're discussing this topic with this guest and attract more influencers like this, but you can't talk much there. So I would suggest to try that.
So to add on to my point, I think you can try IGTV. IGTV is more than 1 minute. So Instagram is going to function something like WhatsApp. So you can have tags, you have like everything there. So there's one particular function called IGTV. You can maybe share your experiences via the channel. It's more than 1 minute. It's something like YouTube, like that. You can try on IGTV. Yes. Like for example, Insta Stories, you also can do a short poll with your readers on what kind of content you want. You have different kind of tools for you to use to engage with your readers.
Yeah, and based on our experience and tracking, right, we have done our H.E.R. show videos and realized that people stop watching after more than 1 minute. So it's not about the longer the better, and I believe in omnichannel marketing. So you think about where are your different marketing mixes. Are you just going to rely on social media? Are you going to have a website to feature yourselves, personal branding? Are you going to be on LinkedIn, right? If you want more content, find me on, maybe on Facebook. That's where you have the whole lot of content. But you see the millennials here today, they are moving to different platforms now. If I'm engaging, so these days, when you engage with secondary school students, and you say, do you use Facebook? So that's dinosaur Facebook, oh my gosh, you're using Facebook. Oh, I say, no, I'm not your friend. So they're on Instagram, and then some on Snapchat, and whatnot. And then it's the next generation of millennials that you're going to target, so you're going to think that way. So understand your target audience. If your target audience are perhaps not the millennials or the older generation, they don't mind longer content, they just like to read what they like to read, they still read books, they still flip things, right? When you target the very young ones, the younger they are, you know, the attention span is getting shorter and shorter. So yeah, have that in mind.
It's like 18 to 25 years old. So can I say that their attention span is somewhere
I think for your industry, right, I think it's best to come up with, I think you still can come up with a lot of content, but then not always come up with all the posts at all.
Yeah.
So something that can come up with a quote or something like that.
A variety.
It's not like very...
So it's a bit like what kind of mentioned,
yes. It depends on what kind of content ultimately, yeah.
Okay, alright. Thank you so much for your participation and your questions. Let's give our panelists a round of applause for the presentation. We just got some little tokens of appreciation for each and every one of them. Thank you so much. Asia Summit on 2nd October, 3rd October is the masterclass and site visit. and H.E.R Malaysia Summit on the 6th November. If you love more information, you can find us on herentrepreneur.com or like us on our Facebook page. And we have our network membership as well if you'd like to join us. But this is also open to the public, it's up to you. But it includes the VIP pass for the summit, which is worth 258 already, and also the monthly sessions here, and you know, directory listing and whatnot. If you need more further information, just approach any of us. And okay, so what we're gonna have next, all right? On 2nd March, it's a Saturday, we're gonna have a chat, a fireside chat or a panel discussion on how do we bring local brand global. In this session, we're gonna have a you know, delegation from China as well. If you'd like to network with people from other regions, so we do have such opportunities. It's gonna be held in a hotel, the Grand Copthorne Waterfront. So you can take down, you can take a picture of it. So there's a PTX link over there. If you like our Facebook page, you can, you know, find all of our events there. Okay. So after 2nd of March, what we have next is an exclusive event here at the Co. So this is a workshop, but this is just to show you that before this actual workshop, we will also do a free session, right, in this office at 11:45 to 2 p.m. On the 11th of March. So he is actually like a disciple, or he's being trained by Deepak Chopra. Okay, he's gonna share with you how to live, you know, living in flow, right? He teaches leadership as well, and you know, it's about mindfulness and things like that. Very rare opportunity because he's flying from the US. If you're available, do drop by. This is like a lunch talk over here at the Co. So do take note. All right, so what's next we have? Okay, so it's just gonna be a video, is that right? Just to show you what we do every year.
Singapore. across diverse business experience, opportunity to network, as well as to exchange ideas. Yeah, I'm sure it's going to be an event that a lot of entrepreneurs are going to be looking out for next year.
Just send it to my friends. Contributed to providing free training programs for marginalized women from low-income groups.